High school boys basketball. Tonight we head to our backyard in St. Paul for a St. Paul City Conference match between Highland Park and Como Park, two plus 500 teams. I'm Mike Peden here with Jeff Williams. We'll get to teams more in a second, but let's get to the starting lineups. Highland Park first, they're starting five. Deion Bradley, number three at guard. Tyshawn Williams, number 11 at guard. Daryl Hill, number 24 at guard. Cordero Washington, number 31 at forward. And Ryan Voigt Fitzpatrick, number 42 at forward. Player to watch for, Tyshawn Williams. Streaky shooter, but he can take the ball to the basket. No one better outside when he's on. Como Park, Terrence Williams at guard, number 11 will get the start, along with Denzel Shaw, number 15 at guard, Bennett Cooper, number 30 at forward, Kenny Kelly, number 44 at center, and number 45, Brandon Berger at forward, Denzel Shaw, the team's leading scorer, second in the St. Paul City Conference, and Steve Scroggins, the head coach, told me the leadership he's showing is overwhelming.
And your officials for the game tonight are Damon Laliberti and Todd Klingsborn.
Well, that was the quickest open I've ever done. But
I've done quicker, Mike.
But a big St. Paul City Conference match with conference implications on the line, of course. Both teams about even overall and in the conference. Of course, they've got to deal with a tough St. Paul Johnson team who's manhandled everybody within the state of Minnesota. Their only two losses are to teams outside the state. We'll get to more about that later.
Laliberti with the ball. They're prepared to jump. Possession goes to Como Park.
They're wearing the black jerseys. Highland Park wearing the white with the blue trim.
From our left to our right.
Out of bounds. Como Park will keep the ball. Highland Park sitting at 9-6. This is the first time they are in position to have a plus 500 season in 5 years. Under John DePerry, his first year head coach. Rebound and the putback by Bennett Cooper. Keep an eye on him. On both teams, four players average double figures. For three, in and out. From Bradley, and we've got a jump ball. Possession arrow favors Highland Park.
Cooper versus Washington.
Inbounding the ball is Williams. From the corner, that's Williams, too strong. Voigt Fitzpatrick was fighting for it, but the rebound goes to Brandon Berger. There's Denzel Shaw, second in the St. Paul City Conference, finding Cooper. No putback from Kelly. Fight for the rebound. Kelly almost had it. Berger can't get the cleanup. And another offensive rebound and a foul on Highland Park. That play looked like what I saw last night with the Gopher women against Northwestern. And one possession, the Gopher women picked up six offensive rebounds. Gopher! Pam Borton joked that the Gophers were padding their stats last night. For three, bullseye! Terrence Williams. He averages 16.6 a game, third in the St. Paul City Conference in scoring, right behind his teammate Denzel Shaw. No response from Daryl Hill, but he gets his own rebound. Kicks out to Washington. Bradley, no good.
In and out the back iron.
They still can't find their shot. But you have to like how both teams are attacking the glass early.
They're both being very aggressive out here. You can tell that they're two evenly matched teams that really feel that they've got a lot at stake tonight. Daryl Hill taking the ball out from underneath the basket. Oh, it's up to Deion Bradley.
Hill for three. Got it.
And Hill nails a three-pointer.
That's Highland Park's first basket. 16-15 to go in half number one. Williams. Used up the dribble. Goes out to Kelly. Misses the two. Rebound Cooper. Pull up, no good. Kelly, rebound. Stripped. And one. Terrence Williams with the cleanup. Williams missed the free throw.
Washington with a rebound.
Hill.
Outlet pass to Hill.
Like the idea of driving to the basket, but against triple coverage, it's hard to get a shot off.
And now we're resetting. Shaw coming across the timeline.
Timeout. Steve Scroggins for Como Park with 15:46 left to go in the first half. So again, we'll talk a little bit more about Derek Shaw, second in the St. Paul City Conference in scoring. As we mentioned, Scroggins really likes his leadership. He scored 30 points against Patrick Henry last week and 31 in their victory over St. Paul Central.
And for high school, those are amazing stats. You'd expect to see that with college. You expect to see that in the pros. But for high school, with 18-minute halves, I mean, that's amazing.
No media timeouts either. Scroggins tells me Shaw is a coach within a coach. Intelligent with the ball, does whatever is needed for the team.
And that's all you can ask for out of your players. And when you have a player like that, you got a diamond in the rough.
For three. That's off target. Rebound goes to Bradley. Finding Williams. Out to Hill.
Hill in the corner for three.
7-6. Como Park with a one-point lead.
And all of Highland Park's scoring has come on two three-pointers by Daryl Hill.
Both of Highland Park's baskets have been three-pointers. Williams with the rebound. Finding Bradley. Washington thought about it. Williams almost loses it but saves possession. Hill. Not this time. Boy, Fitzpatrick.
Hill again. Drives, loses possession. And it appears that it went out of bounds on Como Park. Highland Park will keep the ball.
Indeed they will, and give credit to following their shots. On every possession, they're fighting for offensive rebounds.
The ball's outletted up to Williams up on the point. Hill, top key.
Washington
drives. Highland Park takes a one-point lead, 8-7 with 14:40 remaining in the first half.
Highland Park's first two-pointer. Shaw. Can't get the pull-up.
Rebound by Bradley. Pushing it up in transition. Layup goes up. It's Williams. No good.
And the rebound by number 33 from Highland Park, or Como Park, will get a number for you. Not listed in the program. It will go Highland Park's way. Christopher Stewart stepping in the game for Como Park, and wearing number 21. Bradley bringing it up. Washington drives and draws a foul.
Bennett Cooper picks up the foul.
He had Bradley open on the outlet but decided to drive inside. That was a risky move, but it paid off. He gets free throws. Feel free to jump in. Washington gets
when
the front
end. When I think
end.
Of something to say, I will definitely chime in.
Washington averaging 12.7 points per game coming into tonight. One of four Highland Park players to average double figures. And again, Como Park also averaging four players in double figures. blocking foul. Bennett Cooper draws it.
And for Highland Park, Terrence Lee is now checking into the game as Cordaro Washington takes the bench.
No three from Cooper. Rebound. And the pull up for three, no good from Najee Kennedy. Another offensive rebound, and this time Terrence Williams drains the tray. Highland Park, one of their keys to the game was to hold Como to one possession, and that's why. 10 all.
And so far, it looks like Williams has 8 of the 10 points for Como.
Williams loses the ball. Kennedy with the strip.
Almost picked off.
Looking for his target, but overthrows his target.
And missed the backside of the end zone. It went right out of bounds.
Let me guess, you're getting ready for Super Bowl 45 and a date with the Green Bay Packers?
Of course I am.
For those of you who don't know, Jeff, a diehard Packers fan, grew up in the UP area of Michigan, which is Packer territory.
It's also good high school basketball country.
John DePerry calls timeout for Highland Park. DePerry spent 19 years as an assistant, either with the JV ranks or as an assistant head coach, and now finally getting his chance. He told me he couldn't wait when he heard he got the call. And Steve Scroggins, Como's head coach, told me John DePerry was long overdue to get a shot at a head coaching spot.
Well, I guess to use a football analogy, so was Vince Lombardi. Vince Lombardi had gone through high school coaching, college coaching, assistant coaching in the pros. He was 45 years old before the Green Bay Packers gave him a head start. And we've got the same I can't say it's a problem, but we've got the same situation here with John DePerry. The guy has been in the back. He's been doing all the things right, just waiting for the opportunity. And 19 years later, here it is.
And he's really impressed with how quickly his Highland Park players have bought into his system. That's always key. You got to get the chemistry flowing early if you're going to make big runs. Pull up no good from Terrence Lee. Keshiva Shaw brings it up, younger brother of Denzel Shaw. Kennedy, short, a rebound, Bradley. He's got numbers. Look at that speed. Tried a Michael Jordan-style layup, but he couldn't get the over-under.
Hill battling for the rebound.
And Terrence Lee will draw the foul. Lee averaging 3 points per game. Doesn't get a lot in the score column, but both teams feature a lot of unsung heroes, and we'll talk more about that as the program continues. Lee gets the front, misses the back, gives Highland a one-point lead. 12-09 in half number one.
Terrence!
Long two, swish. Vaughn Pledger. He averages 5.4 a game. Both schools not afraid to use their bench. Williams for three, bullseye.
They're scoring so fast right here, and substituting so fast, I can't even keep up with them.
We need a statistician.
That I am not.
I could be, but I'm doing this. No response from Williams. And there's the Tyshawn Williams. Out to Hill. Going to Williams inside. And he draws a foul. We've got Terrence Williams in Como Park wearing number 11 and Tyshawn Williams at Highland Park wearing number 11. it could be liable for some confusion among the fans.
And don't forget a broadcaster here named Williams, too. Keeping it all in the family.
And it comes Sunday, I think we're heading to an arena that shares the namesake.
Yes, we will. Fast break.
No Williams, but look at that layup from Kashiva Shaw. Described by Steve Scroggins as a sophomore general for Como Park.
Wait till he becomes a senior.
That's a dangerous thing with the underclassmen that develop early.
10:48 left in the first half.
Lee got bumped, no foul called. Kennedy fighting for the strip. Won't get it, Highland Park ball. Kenny Kelly going back in for the Cougars.
Highland Park with the ball. Deion Bradley gets a pass near the timeline. They set up their next play.
Tyshawn Williams driving right, too strong. Evan St. Martin fights for the rebound, but he loses it to Denzel Shaw. Finding an open Kashiva, but he can't finish. And now Bradley's moving up. He's got numbers, but pulls up instead, too strong. Rebound
Rims
Denzel
on
Shaw.
On the back wire.
Como with numbers now. Shaw, spinorama, gets the roll. Don't blink, you'll miss something. This tempo, lightning fast. 10 minutes to go in half number one. Feels longer. And a foul on Ryan Voigt Fitzpatrick. You wouldn't believe we've only had 8 minutes go by at this point.
I'm already exhausted.
It's a staple of St. Paul City Conference basketball, though, especially for the boys. Always up-tempo, always quick. Just a lot of fun.
Kennedy's now in for Como.
Denzel Shaw out to Kennedy again. Kashiva out to Kennedy. No three. Rebound Bradley. He's got two on one. And Williams will push it for the basket.
That makes 5 points for Tyshawn Williams for Highland Park.
You sure you're not related to the two Williams out on the court?
To my brothers, to another mother.
That's exactly what Crystal Flint would say, and we'll see here at the Gopher Women's Alumni Game. Kashiva Shaw with the swish. 18-16, Como Park over Highland Park.
So in 2 minutes of play, Shaw comes off the bench, and he's already got four. 18-16 in favor of Como.
Evan
St. Just
Martin.
Under 8 minutes left in the half.
Voigt Fitzpatrick thought about it, but goes to Williams inside, and he gets fouled. And so Tyshawn Williams, who averages 14.5 points per game, will have a chance to tie it up again as Steve Scroggins pulls Kenny Kelly aside to have a word with him. You want to talk about a 6 degrees in the case of Steve Scroggins for Como Park. He works at St. Paul Central as an administrator over there. In the same building with one of his coaching adversaries, Scott Howell of St. Paul Central. But they're only adversaries on the court. It's also the place where Willie Taylor coaches the girls team for St. Paul Central. And Williams made both free throws on the other end, and Kashiva Shaw missed. Bennett Cooper can't get the rebound. Tyshawn Williams with the board. Bradley.
Voigt Fitzpatrick was down, tried picking up the block, or tried picking up the charge, but the officials didn't bite. It was a non-call.
Bradley going out to Lee, but he's too strong. Rebound Cooper. Kennedy to Kashiva for three. to the right. Rebound Lee.
Deshaun Williams pushes it up the court.
16-footer. No good. Rebound. Terrence Williams. Terrence Williams takes it himself, but he can't get the bounce. Bennett Cooper, third time is the charm. He's padding his own stats.
And he's got four on the night.
And those are just points.
Denzel's a bad pass.
And Denzel Shaw with the steal. Coma Park in transition. But Shaw's pass is off target.
Pledger's back in for Como. And Roy Fitzpatrick takes a seat for Highland Park.
7:16 remaining in the first half. And as up-tempo as this game has been, not a lot of fouls. Pretty clean game. Officials letting them play. Tyshawn out to Bradley, thought about a three, drives instead, and one. When you've got speed, as most of these players have exhibited, that gives you an option outside or in.
Tyshawn Bradley picked up his fourth point of the game. It's 20-20 tie, and he's on the line for one.
Man, that's the same as my vision.
And Terrence Lee checks into the ball game.
Bradley averaging 11.1 points per game. And I jinxed him. You know, I got to stop doing that. I got to stop bringing up their scoring numbers at the free throw line.
You've always been good about that. Deshaun Williams picks off the pass.
Gonna say
turnover on Shaw.
Bradley for three, and he's fouled.
That's Pledger picking up the foul, bumped him as he was in the air behind the three-point line.
So three free throws coming for Deion Bradley. I was going to say, every time I mention some type of statistic when a player's at the free throw line, they miss, especially if I'm at a Lynx game.
See? Bradley nails the first free throw. That's his fifth point of the night.
And he made it because I didn't bring up any of his stats.
And you're going to keep it that way, right? You're not going to jinx either player for any player from either team from now on out.
There's a second one. Highland Park High School, home to a notable alumni who you might recognize, Jack Morris, who is a part of four World Series championship teams, the 84 Tigers, the 91 Twins, and the 92 and 93 Blue Jays.
Shaw pushes the ball up.
Toma Park slowing things down a bit. Kaishiva Shaw. In and out. Off Como Park. I'd like to remind you, at halftime, we were going to have an interview with the JV head coach for Como Park. Mike Myers will also have first half stats and analysis.
Offensive foul. It was Jordan Stewart picking up an offensive foul, pushing off.
Chance for Como Park to trim Highland's largest lead of the game.
And Bennett Cooper makes an adjustment just before taking the ball out. Todd Klingsborn looks on.
Shaw, swish for two.
And keeping in line with tonight's tradition, Shaw picked up his fourth point of the game.
Someone's going to have to get more than four.
Bradley pulls up, 16-footer out.
Bennett Cooper with the rebound. Kaishiva Shaw was looking for Berger, and our cameraman has to duck.
Knocked his headphones off.
Well, I know how he feels. I covered the Gopher women's victory over Northwestern yesterday, and a errant ball came my way, but we talked about it off broadcast. That was a little thrill to catch.
That's all you've been talking about for the last 3 days, Mike.
I don't know if it was three. Well, how could it be 3 days? It only happened yesterday.
It feels like 3 days.
Voight Fitzpatrick, too strong. Bennett Cooper with the board, but he loses it. And Daryl Hill with the finish.
Okay, that's his eighth point of the game.
So someone does have more than four. Highland Park up 25-22. Bennett Cooper looking to tie it. Can't do it. Bradley with the rebound. He's got numbers. Drives right and blocked by Terrence Williams. Como with numbers. Kaishiba takes it himself and gets the floater.
For coming off the bench, Shaw has now 6 points.
Daryl Hill for three. No good. Scramble. And he gets his own rebound, but falls down. Now they're fighting for it. Just like an NFL scrum when there's a fumble.
And the possession goes to Como Park.
Yeah, to finish up that story on the errant balls, unfortunately at the high school and collegiate level, since they only use so many, you can't keep them. So I don't have a souvenir. Bennett Cooper, in and out. Bradley had the rebound, but he stepped on the line. Como Park ball.
Turnover. Como Park ball. Terrence Williams taking the ball out from behind the backboard. At the baseline.
Bennett Cooper from the corner. No good. Denzel Shaw.
He thought about it and then he drove in. Denzel Shaw for two. That makes six for him on the night.
So that second guessing pays off.
Daryl Hill.
Going to Voight Fitzpatrick. He's open and he finishes. You can't leave anybody open in the paint.
Shaw pushes the ball up, slows the tempo down. We got 3.5 minutes left in the first half.
Denzel Shaw travels. We'd like to thank GrandStadium.tv for providing an outlet to webcast these games for you. They've been kind to us all season, giving us a place to stream the games online for the fans. Hill, short, rebound, Denzel Shaw. 3:10 in half number one. Kennedy to Denzel. Loses the ball. Picks it up, but he's short. Tyshawn Williams going to Daryl Hill, who has a one-on-one. And that's the way you beat Najee's Kennedy's coverage. Kennedy waiting for the charge. Hill decides to pull up, and it pays off.
Kennedy slowing things down. Passes over to Denzel Shaw. Denzel Shaw at the top of the key. Terrence Williams on the wing. He drives, he shoots. And that ball's going nowhere. Pulled down by Fitzpatrick. Tongue-tied here tonight, Mike. Last time we did a game together, I couldn't see. Maybe one of these days we'll get it all right.
Voight Fitzpatrick is blocked but fouled. Free throws coming.
You can hear the slap of the wrist way over here.
Jeff
Todd Klingsborn with the call.
Jeff and I covering the Lynx for a couple seasons now. And yet, after a while, you can hear the difference between the ball and skin.
That's for sure. That did not sound like leather.
Voight Fitzpatrick misses his first. He averages 3.2 a game.
And he has yet to score in this game.
And he's not going to make headlines. He doesn't score a lot of points, but John DePerry told me he's a big rebounder, and in his mind, sometimes rebounding is more important than scoring.
Well, I didn't get the headlines in my high school career either because I was a rebounder, not a scorer. Of course, now I'm sitting in the broadcast booth instead of out on the court.
Pledge. Missed it.
Bradley comes away with it.
2 minutes left.
Outlets over to Daryl Hill. Back up to Bradley.
Open Tyshawn Williams, but he doesn't go for three.
Terrence Lee with the screen. But he zigged, and Bradley zagged, and it was almost a turnover.
Williams from the corner. Bullseye.
And nails a three.
Highland Park now with their biggest lead of the game at six.
Tashawn Williams now in double digits with 10 points.
Pledger is fouled. Again, Pledger averaging 5.4 a game. Your thoughts on the first half?
I'm actually surprised. I thought that Como would pull away with it, but instead we're starting to see Highland Park now with a 6-point lead as we have 1 minute and 21 seconds left in the first half.
The largest lead for either team has been six. Both teams playing to what you might expect on paper, with Highland Park at 9-6, Como Park at 7-6, both teams even in St. Paul City Conference play. Ledger misses the back end.
He's 1-for-1, 3 points on the night. As we near 1 minute remaining in the first half, Bradley top of the key.
Lloyd Fitzpatrick looking for Williams, but he loses it to Kashiva Shaw. And now Denzel missed the floater. Ledger's blocked. Tyshawn Williams.
He drives, he's going in. And two more for Tyshawn Williams. With 45 seconds left, that pushes the Highland Park lead to seven.
Como Park may hold for the final shot. There's no shot clock in high school basketball in Minnesota. Pledger blocked again.
And loses it. Williams picks it up. We've got 25 seconds left. Pulls back out.
Highland Park may elect to hold for the final shot. Ten seconds. Highland will make a
and
move.
They're holding for the final shot.
Got to make a move soon, though.
Bradley top the key over to Williams on the left. Williams drives. And he nails a buzzer beater. Time was expiring, but the shot left his hand.
And Tyshawn Williams, an exclamation point for Highland Park. Only fitting that he gets the last basket in half number one.
Considering he has 14 points, he's the one who's carrying this team on his shoulder. Between Tyshawn Williams and Daryl Hill, that's the majority of your points, folks.
Mike Beaton here with Stephen Pastor, assistant coach for Como Park High School. And Stephen, tell me what has made Como Park a consistent plus 500 team the last few years.
Well, we've been working hard. All summer we've been just trying to, you know, get it together and you know, just everybody's been doing AAU for the most part. And then lately we've been actually doing some pretty intense workouts and practices, you know, during the season. So I believe that's one of the key things right there. So,
what are the strongest aspects of the Como Park team? Because they play in a conference that gets overshadowed by Johnson. They've been dominant the last few years. So what does Como Park bring to the St. Paul City Conference?
Well, we bring a lot of intensity. I believe we're real explosive. You know, a lot of teams might not believe in some of our guys, but I believe that we show a lot of strength, you know, under the whole program. We show a lot of strength that goes on with our school. So, you know, the workouts are very intense. So I think we'll come up against a lot of teams this season.
And who should we keep an eye on tonight and perhaps for the remainder of the season for St. Paul City Conference followers?
We have Ben Cooper, Denzel Shaw, Terrence Williams, Kay Shaw, and a lot of other key players, but those are one of the dominant key players right there is Terrence, Denzel, and Ben for sure. So, you know, you should keep tuned to them.
Well, thanks for taking time to speak with us, and good luck tonight against Highland Park.
All right, thank you.
Stephen Pastor, assistant head coach for Como Park. Mike Beaton here with Andre Ellis, assistant head coach for Highland Park. Andre, a Highland Park player himself, went to Southwest State to play college basketball, and now you find yourself in the coaching ranks. So tell me, what's different about the coaching experience versus playing?
It's a lot of teaching. You got to stay on the kids, teach them the basics. It's not as advanced, everybody's not as advanced as in college, so you got to just start from the beginning.
And what were some of the things that you taught the Highland Park players this season and previous seasons as you came in as a coach?
Just play with a lot of intensity. A lot of defense is the key here. Just learning every day is a big part of basketball.
And what are you hoping to instill on the current Highland Park roster, who sits at 9-6 and right now looking at their first plus 500 season in 5 years?
Just playing hard. I mean, every day, don't take a play off. Just go out there and just do your best. That's all we can ask for the kids.
And perhaps share some insights on your playing days and maybe what is different in today's game versus when you played in high school.
When I played, I mean, I had great players like Mo Hargrove, Aaron Howard, Robin Jackson. We all knew the game. We've been playing forever together. But now we get kids that's Deion Bradley. He just transferred in from Chicago. He doesn't know the kids as well. So just learning each other and playing together is the big part.
Well, thanks for taking the time to speak with us, and good luck tonight against Como Park.
Thanks.
Andre Ellis, assistant head coach for Highland Park. Mike Beaton here with Mike Myers and Antonio Washington of Como Park's JV squad. Mike, the JV head coach, Antonio, a player. Now, we were talking about unsung heroes in the first half. In a sense, JV and the ninth grade teams also play those unsung heroes because they play a lot of minutes, but they don't get a lot of face time.
Right.
Feel free to jump in.
Okay. like you said, you was watching the varsity game, and a lot of those kids played for me, so... Like, when you playing JV and freshman, it's for us as coaches to get the kids motivated and get them up to par to play on the varsity level. And this year, I'm blessed to have some wonderful talent. Antonio Washington to the left of me is my go-to guy, my star player, my leader. So he can talk a little bit about the season, then I'll let you ask some questions, then I'll slide in towards the end and talk a little bit more about it, too.
So, Antonio, again, you don't get a lot of face time being on JV and getting with a lot of varsity matches, but what do you get playing at junior varsity that will help mold you for when you make that transition?
Well, I get pretty good coaching. You know, he helps me work on, attitude, keeping the right attitude, mindset. He helps me with a lot of things that, you know, that I'm going to have to face when I get to the varsity level, you know. It helps a lot because we practice against varsity and, you know, like just looking at the varsity team and looking at the JV team, it's a big difference. And it's a big difference in the game, so.
What would you say is the most important aspect to develop playing in ninth grade and junior varsity basketball before you make the switch to varsity?
The speed and stamina, you know, it's like, The whole varsity game is much faster, is more intense, and you have to deal with more, and it's much more harder than the ninth grade and the JV level.
And tell me, what do you learn the most by watching the varsity players, watching students, young men, they're older than you are, but they have the experience. What do you take from them?
Well, I take a lot from the from the captains, you know, like how they present themselves and how they carry themselves on the court and off the court. And it helps me a lot, like in school and outside of school, like when people, you know, like when a teammate is not doing, you know, something that he's supposed to or something that he's not supposed to be doing, it helps me a lot because I look at them and, you know, I see that they're correcting their team and it helps me, you know, step up my slack, so.
And I'm going to throw a little curveball out here. Is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on TV, on SPNN, or online at Grand Stadium?
Yeah, I'd like to say hi to my mom, my family, and all my friends out there.
And what do you think of Mike Myers here?
Oh, he's a great coach. I'm glad I have the opportunity to be coached by him. He helped me a lot. He helped me a lot with a lot of things I go through, so it's a real wonder to have him here.
Well, you certainly have the positive mentality and certainly the mindset that will prepare you for varsity ball, and so I'm looking forward to seeing you dress up in a varsity jersey, perhaps this season or especially down the line. But thanks for taking the time to speak with us, and good luck as you continue the rest of the junior varsity season.
Thank you.
That was Antonio Washington and Mike Myers of Como Park's junior varsity squad. Once again, thank you and good luck.
Thank you.
So as we wrap up with that, let's take a look at the first half stats and analysis as we bring back Jeff Williams. And Jeff, I know you got the numbers verified as a...
I got the numbers verified. Boy, how wrong I was. No, actually, I missed a couple of things in here, but that's with
you're
any
a good
statistician.
Reporter.
Just I need to make sure we got the facts correct. Now,
exactly.
With Como Park, we have Terrence Williams leading all leading the team with 8 points. He's got one foul. Then we have Denzel Shaw with 6 points, no fouls. The other Shaw,
Kashiva.
Two Shaws, Kashiva. Kashiva also has 6 points and no fouls. And Bennett Cooper has 4 points and one foul. And we have Kennedy with 3 points and two fouls. Como, 27 points at the half. Now going to Highland Park, they have 36 points, leading by six. We have leading all scorers is Tyshawn Williams with 14 points, zero fouls. Daryl Hill has 10 points and one foul. Deion Bradley, 5 points, no fouls. Cordaro Washington with 4 points and two fouls. Ryan Voigt Fitzpatrick, 2 points and one foul. Terrence Lee, 1 point and one foul. With Jordan Stewart with one foul. And that's a look at our statistics. Don't even ask me about rebounds. I didn't even bother. There were a lot of them tonight.
And that actually goes back to the keys to the game. In Como Park, their big one was securing the glass. And so far, they've had a difficult time doing that, especially late in the first half.
Oh, they have. And if you're going to win games, you got to control the boards. And it just so far, neither team has really controlled the boards. There's been a lot of sloppy rebound, a lot of sloppy shots so far in this first half. And I think that both coaches are going to go into this locker room and they're going to tell their teams, guys, you got to control those rebounds. Control your shots, be efficient, and that's what's going to win this game. I mean, 6 points, that's not insurmountable for anybody. And so I can easily see a very, very close second half.
And on Highland Park's end, their big focus was containing Terrence Williams. He has 8 points so far, but the second chance opportunities and really the transition game has been the difference.
Oh, absolutely it has. I mean, it was coming in, it was Williams versus Williams. Well, Tyshawn Williams has been leading all scorers with 14. Terrence only has 8. Como's got to pick it up a little bit. You know, they've got to really play efficient. They got to play smart. They got to make sure that when they got that opportunity to get the ball in the hole, they do it. And that's what they have not done successfully in this first half.
Highland Park wearing white. They have the first possession of the second half. Como Park wearing black. There's Deion Bradley. He's got a lot of speed. Highland Park ball. And so we'd like to inform you that our next televised game will be the Gopher Women's Alumni Game, which will take place 2 days from now in the chronologically. But, of course, stay tuned to GrandStadium.tv for updates. Our next high school game, as Tyshawn Williams banks the three, will be February 8th when the North St. Paul girls visit Richfield to take on a top 10 team in Class 3A.
And that's another key to the game for Como Park, as Bennett Cooper hits in a layup. Another key for Como Park is to make sure that they can contain Tyshawn Williams, and they have not done anything to really shut him down in this game so far. And considering he just came out with another score. Did you catch who shot that one?
Tyshawn Williams. I believe he has the first 5 points of this half, and we're going to have a timeout with 17 minutes left. Steve Scroggins going to try to get his Como Park team back in order. And speaking of Tyshawn Williams, John DePerry mentioned he's a streaky shooter, but he can take the ball to the basket, and when he's on, there's no one better with the outside shot.
And it's not only the outside shooting, it's also taking the ball in on transition. There's been numerous times in this game so far that we'd see Williams streaking up the court, and he's hard to stop. He's hard to defend against.
He's got a lot of speed, too, the fastest kid on the team.
Cordaro Washington on the rebound, stepped on the end line, remains Como Park ball. As our cameraman struggles to get out of the way.
This is a small gym. Denzel Shaw with the give and go. Como Park down by 10. They led early in this half, and then traded baskets with Highland Park before the Scots pulled away late in the first.
Bradley with the ball. Comes to the top of the key.
Highland Park slowing things down. The longest possession we've seen by far. Daryl Hill missed the three. Tyshawn Williams with the board.
Rebound.
And inside, feeding to Hill.
And that pushes the Highland Park lead to 12.
Matt.
15 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in regulation.
Matches their largest. Highland Park forcing a turnover, 15:44 left.
Yo, brings it up to Bradley, who walks it up the court, crosses the timeline, and gives it right back to Hill. And this is when efficiency matters. If Highland Park can score every time and control the clock, they can win. And I think John DePerry knows that.
He's been around for a few years, 19 to be precise, before getting his first chance at a head coaching job.
Now it's Washington to Hill. Back to Washington. Over to Williams.
No foul called.
As the other Williams takes
Terrence
it in
Williams.
Fast break. And he nails it and one.
I thought he was going to dunk. But two
I
points.
I think so did he. He comes up smiling.
2 points are 2 points, no matter how flashy they are. And Terrence
that
Williams.
Brings the lead. The Highland Park lead has been cut down to 10.
So Terrence Williams will try to make this a 9-point game. And he does.
And that's his 11th point on the game, third of the half.
Terrence Williams, also a football player. Steve Scroggins told me he has some great moments on the gridiron. Daryl Hill, bang. In fact, it's not uncommon to see a lot of football players carry over to basketball in the winter. At the boys level, that is. Deion Bradley with the steal. Tyshawn Williams. Cordero Washington turns a broken play into 2 points. Not quite what Highland scripted, but they're continuing their run. Terrence Williams draws the pushing foul. ...14-19 left in the second half, which, as we know, in any level of basketball is an eternity. Right now, Como Park trying to figure out how to get back in. Williams loses the handle.
Williams loses it to Williams.
And once again, Highland Park will slow things down. Not for long. Daryl Hill, bullseye.
3 points for Hill. And that's Hill's 17th on the night.
And that brings the Highland Park lead to 17. Denzel Shaw short on the floater.
And Daryl Hill stands there with his arms open, and the ball comes right to him.
Count it, Terrence Lee. Como Park led this game early, and in the last 10 minutes or so, it's been all Highland Park. As Jeff calculates these numbers, making sure his facts are right, as he always does. Terrence Lee can't complete the three-point play. Pledger with the rebound. Como Park going forward on three. Bullseye, Terrence Williams. Williams, the only Como Park player, finding momentum in the second half. Deion Bradley with the over-under. 55-37, Highland over Como. Kaishiba Shaw with the kiss off the glass.
And this is another one of the stretches where they're scoring faster than I can run.
Timeout, John DePerry with 12:58 to go.
Thank you, John. It gives me a chance to finally finish up, making sure I got everything tallied right.
No, 12:58 to go. I think he's adding up the numbers on my Highland notes. So we'll talk a little bit more about Como Park, and one of the players who's starting but haven't heard much about, Brandon Berger, only his second year playing basketball. He does what's asked, but he does a lot off the court as well. He's a youth church counselor, and he attends group meetings every Wednesday. It's something he's very passionate about and something Scroggins is proud to have with Berger on the team.
Well, it's always good to have passions, and especially when you're still a youth, you develop your passion, and it can take you everywhere you want to be as an adult. And it's good to see these kids of today actually having some passion about something positive.
And on Highland Park's end, half of it, their team, honor roll students, they take pride in their high GPAs. And John DePerry told me the academic first responsibilities were instilled before he got here. And he said he would step up for his kids in a heartbeat. And John DePerry's kids are stepping up for him in a big way with 12:55 remaining in the second half as Highland Park has a 16-point lead.
And we're playing the Bradley to Hill to Washington game again.
Bradley stops, starts, going to lead. Terrence Williams loses it. Going to Kaishiba Shaw. Holy cow, did you see that?
I thought I was watching a young Michael Jordan.
Bradley to Lee. No bounce. And Terrence Williams with the rebound. Brings it up again. Kaishiba Shaw can't handle it. Saves possession. And gets a tough shot.
Shaw is single-handedly keeping Como Park to life in the second half.
Margin is 12. The fans slowly getting the energy back.
The momentum shift has occurred. Now the question is, can John DePerry's team just continue to play their kind of game?
This is an element we've seen more of since the switch to halves 5 years ago. Scoring runs and more tests of endurance.
Deshaun Williams.
Foul on Como.
Christopher Stewart picks up the foul.
Tyshawn Williams picks it up in the backcourt, which is allowed. And an offensive foul on Highland Park.
Kennedy with the ball.
Foul on Highland.
And it looks like Denzel Shaw will be going to the line. Oh, not a shooting foul.
This is why we're not on the floor officiating this game. Terrence Williams is at a big half, feeding inside to Denzel Shaw.
Todd Kingsborn warns Como players about something.
May have been delay of game. I saw him touching his head. We know there's no shot clock, so that doesn't mean shot clock violation. My guess is delay of game.
As Como presses.
Boyd Fitzpatrick open. And we mentioned, doesn't score a lot of points, but he'll make the newspapers tonight.
Como tried to press in that possession, and as soon as...
And as soon as you were about to finish that statement, Kaishiva Shaw gets a three. They're just not giving you a break with these stats.
No, they are not, but as soon as Como or Highland was able to break the press, that left Dwight Fitzpatrick wide open for the layup. If they continue like that, it's going to be an interesting last 10 minutes here.
Cordero Washington said they had to feed to him. So
11
far
point
haven't.
Game with 10 minutes left.
And now Como Park finding their rhythm. Andre Perry's number 33. No three. And Voight Fitzpatrick.
Patrick had the rebound, but he pounded it on the baseline.
That might be a small baseline, but the officials still see it.
Rod Fitzpatrick comes out. John DePerry just glares at him.
Andre Showalter.
Clearly
Perry.
The coach was not happy on that play.
Denzel Shaw fights his way
Denzel
around coverage.
Shaw puts it in for another. He's already doubled his production here in the second half. He has 12.
Averaging 17.8 a game, getting close to his average. It's a 9-point game, but you get the sense that Como Park has their confidence back. Washington and one.
And even the Como cheerleaders are getting into it. They were pretty silent in the first half.
I wonder if we'll see any for the Lynx at some point. You'll see some cheerleaders for girls basketball and women's basketball.
Well, don't even get me started on that. They used to have this thing called an energy team, and I always said it sucked the energy right out of the Target Center. Washington misses the free throw.
No 3-point play. Kennedy. Oh, that would have been big. But Bennett Cooper, too strong. And Bradley with the board. NBA three, no good from Tyshawn Williams. Highland Park going for the strip, but unsuccessful. Como Park, they've had some successes over the last few years. Back in 2008 and in 2003, they made the state quarterfinals, once as a member of 4A and once as a member of 3A. In fact, in 2003, they made it all the way to the semis.
Well, this team clearly has some talent. It's just a matter of whether or not they can or will put it all together in a complete game.
Kaishiva Shaw, he's had a big game. Getting the runner. Como pursuing. Tyson Williams down with space. And he was looking for Nate Anderson. Can't find him.
Kaishiva Shaw was asking for help there. And Kaishiva Shaw goes up for the layup and picks up the blocking foul on Bradley.
And he is pumped.
Shaw, who started the second half with 6 points, now has 17. He is single-handedly keeping Como Park in this game.
Steve Scroggins tells me this kid likes to fly. He often has to pull him back. But they've been trying him at different positions, and he likes to have fun when he's on the court. And you saw just the look on his face. He's having fun, even if his team's down. In fact, he scored 12 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists, and 3 steals off the bench against Central. This kid can do a lot. This is the back end, but it's the lead's now 8. Como slowly coming back. Williams can't get the foul, but he gets the basket. New player in for Como Park, Wyatt Johnson. Kaishiva Shaw. That was a fake three. Como Park can't save possession. 7:56 to go in the second half. 63-53. Highland Park over Como Park. In the most high-flying game I've seen this season. Washington, 14-footer, short. Daryl Hill with the rebound, no cleanup. And Kennedy with the rebound. Kaishiva Shaw, he's hot. Can't finish. Como Park ball.
As we go into the last 7.5 minutes in regulation, Tayshawn Williams leads all scorers with 21 for Highland Park. Daryl Hill has 18 and Kaishiva Shaw also has 18 for Como, to lead Como.
Pledger, short, rebound Washington. Washington with the rebound, so, and he gets his own cleanup. So Kennedy is wearing number 40. The numbers have been switched around, so Kennedy wearing 40, Pledger wearing 24. But no definitions needed for Kaishiva Shaw. He's doing everything he can to keep his Como Park team alive. Daryl Hill can't get the mid-range J. Sends a Como Park runs.
Denzel Shaw picks up the rebound, pushes it up. Denzel Shaw with the rebound, goes up again, and it's blocked. They're playing volleyball with the ball now. Who comes up with it? Traveling on Daryl Hill. Como Park ball.
You get the sense Como's one break away from scaring Highland Park.
I think right now Como is already scaring Highland Park. It's just a matter of whether they can terrify Highland Park. And we're not quite at that level yet, with 6 minutes and 7 seconds remaining in regulation. Andre Perry takes the ball out.
Pledger, big three-pointer. And John DePerry calls timeout. You think he's terrified now?
I think he's getting there.
6 minutes to go. That's
seven
an eternity.
Seven-point lead with 6 minutes left. That is not insurmountable by any stretch of the imagination.
And we know what's insurmountable or not. We covered a game last year with the Lynx where they were up by 30 against the Connecticut Sun, and the Sun came all the way back to force overtime. The Lynx held on to win that game.
And then I traveled with Tony Gear down to Indianapolis at the end of the Lynx season last year, and the Lynx looked like they were going to be out of it in the first half, but yet they battled back, and even though they didn't really have anything to play for as far as playoff positioning because they were already eliminated, they ended up tying it up, forced overtime, and actually won it there when everybody thought they were out.
And the same thing happened when Tony and I went to Chicago to cover their road game against the Sky. Lynx are down by 12. They forced overtime, won it in overtime, and basically turned a six-hour trip into a five-minute game.
And right now, Como Park looked like they were going to return to the press, but they're just in man-to-man.
Como Park deciding not to risk over-pursuing.
And we're playing Washington to Hill, to Williams. Back to Bradley. Washington, back to Williams.
Steal by Perry. Channing on.
But Andre Perry ended up knocking it out of bounds, giving Highland Park the ball with 5:25 left in regulation.
Highland Park all about killing clock.
So Williams. Sean Williams misses the three-pointer.
Williams with the rebound. Pledger again, can't get the bounce. Might have been a little
Sean
too
Williams
quick.
Sean Williams gets the rebound. Over to Washington. Washington will go to the line.
Not what Como Park was looking for.
That was Kennedy picking up the... Najee Kennedy picking up the foul.
And Cordero Washington makes the front end, dare I say this, 12.7 points per game. The substitutions are being made. Steve
he's
Scroggins
got 12.7 points per game, and he's got 13 points right now. Now
14.
Brought it up to 14. He's just passed his average.
I did not jinx anyone this time. There might be hope. It's a 9-point game again. And Steve Scroggins calls timeout with 5:06 remaining. Not a bad time to strategize.
9-point deficit, 5 minutes left. 3 three-pointers turning this game right around into a tie. I think the biggest thing that Scroggins needs to stress to his team is defense. If they can just pull the rebounds down, not turn over the ball, I think they'll still feel they've got a chance to win this game.
In fact, he's right now talking with his assistant coaches. He really gets into the game. He doesn't like to talk to folks before the game or even after the game. He said he really gets into it, but he was really excited to have Como Park featured on local television and online with a national audience.
Now for John DePerry, it comes down to ball control. Control the clock, control the ball, high efficiency. You can win. They're up by 9. But the biggest thing I think that John DePerry's telling his team right now is don't be stupid. Don't do something that will turn this, control the turnovers.
Exactly. We will have interviews with players of the game on both teams following the conclusion of this game, whether it ends in regulation or in overtime, if Como Park can trim that 9-point deficit. There's Shaw. He's had a big game. Going to his older brother. Travel.
And that's exactly the stuff that Steve Scroggins did not need for this team, is now they're playing a game against the clock.
And we're running out of time. 4:45 left.
Damon Laliberti, the official just yelled out, "Don't hold each other." I think he just gave both teams a stern warning.
And it's shown up in the fouls. Neither team in the penalty. Highland with one to give. Cuomo with two.
Daryl Hill went up for the shot. Got hammered below. Marquise Midori picking up the foul. Andre Perry.
Daryl Hill missed the front end, and as most coaches would say, that's what you would call a good foul. But they usually only say that if they miss a free throw. Missed both. So a chance for Como Park. Denzel Shaw in the paint, short. Highland Park
down by Washington.
Highland Park doing a great job clogging up the paint late.
Nate Anderson in the game.
Highland Park knows the clock is on their side. They theoretically could run out the clock for the last 3 minutes and 39 seconds.
Theoretically, but I think what will happen is they'll start having fouls called at that time.
Bradley
like
draws
right
the
there.
Foul.
Terrence Williams on the, picks up the foul. That sends Bradley to the line.
Cuomo now out of fouls to give. Minutes left, but give credit to the officials for the way they've handled this game. I mean, it's been high flying. There's been a lot of scrums, a lot of rumbling going on, and they just let them play through it.
You have to give the officials credit in this game. They're not calling a tight game, but they're not letting the game get out of hand. They're calling a very fair game, very even-handed game. That's what any player and any coach can ever ask for an officiating crew at all levels of sport, no matter what the event. As Cordaro Washington pulls it out to Deion Bradley, as the clock winds down with 3 minutes remaining in regulation, Highland has a 9-point lead.
Highland Park with a chance to ice the game.
Daryl Hill drives, misses, and one for Daryl Hill, who gets his own rebound and the putback.
Padding his stats again.
He's got 20 points on the night. He usually averages 13 points per game, and tonight he's just had a really big night, come out with 20.
That's something that John DePerry told me, is that every night, two or three different players on Highland's team will come up big. It's never the same players. And he really likes that diversity with his offense. And that just might be the last push Highland needed to secure the victory and go to 10-6 on the year. They got a beating from St. Paul Johnson, but again, St. Paul Johnson coming off that undefeated state championship run, still a very tough team. And for all these schools, Como and Highland and Humboldt, that are trying to build, the focus may not be just solely taking down Johnson or trying to be as good as they are, but building up to it and letting things happen. Wyatt Johnson going inside to Denzel Shaw, who draws a foul. That stops the clock with 2:22 left. Highland Park now out of fouls to give. the game's key moment came when DePerry called timeout when he was looking at a 7-point lead, and Highland Park has done enough to keep that lead from collapsing.
John DePerry still calling out instructions to his team. He's yelling about rebounds.
He was talking to Fitzpatrick. Said, got a rebound, Fitz. Well, that wasn't Fitz, but I'm sure he'll take it anyway. If only we could mic up the coaches. I'm not sure if we'd want to hear everything they'd have to say, but that would provide an insight.
Well, it definitely would. As Hill goes in for another layup, missed. Terrence Williams has been pretty cold this half with only 6 points in the second half. And now you can pretty much say that this game is on ice with a 14-point lead for the visiting Highland Park.
There is a 10-second
pass. Anderson back. Still continues to hold the ball. Steve Scroggins sitting on the bench. He knows that this game is slipping away. Deion Bradley. To Daryl Hill.
Oh, Terrence Williams with the steal by himself, and he loses his footing.
Terrence Williams had a wide open shot at the basket, but he dropped the ball and could not hold on to it.
He took his eyes off the ball for a second. I think he was looking to slam it home. And as soon as he looked back down, he realized, where'd the ball go?
Now Como's back in on the press, which once again, oh, again. Almost broken, but now turnover.
Kaisiva Shaw.
Nate Anderson fouls Shaw,
who still has a smile on his face.
Kaisiva
even though
Shaw, even though they're losing, he's still having a ball.
Steve wasn't kidding when he said he likes to have fun on the court. But it's good to see a kid with such high spirits, even when his team is down. You know that's only going to build, and that's just going to bleed over to his teammates.
Well, not only that, but as he develops as a player and as a person, it's only going to help him out in getting to the next level. I mean, I can see college coaches and scouts having their eye on him in another year or two. He's got talent, but more than that, he's got attitude and ambition.
And Como Park
under a minute, less than a minute remaining in the ball game.
Como Park not giving up. They're still going, fighting for it on defense. Making Highland work. As Highland content to run out the clock.
Another turnover.
Terrence Williams this time will get the finish.
Shaw.
And Steve Scroggins will call timeout with 28.8 seconds left. Game out of reach, but as coaches say, you only get 36 minutes to instruct your teammates and improve them for the next game. So they'll take every advantage they can.
All right, now it's a scrimmage. It's really what it is. It's a scrimmage. They know they're out of the ball game, but you don't give up. You keep playing right to the final buzzer. And if anything, this is an opportunity to develop players who normally don't get that opportunity.
And another reason why you don't see many teams give up, it's a short season. They only played 25, 26 games before they start section play, which is officially the first round of the playoffs.
Oh, and that's more than I had when I was in high school in Michigan. We got 20 games.
And how'd you do?
Me personally or us
well,
as a
you,
team?
You,
me
the
personally,
team?
Defense, sat the bench. That's how I got to be a better broadcaster. But as far as our team, our team was really one of the better ones that our small school put up over the years. We, as in junior varsity, we won the Skyline Division Championship. We pushed on to a couple of levels in the state tournament play, and then it was the year after I left high school that team actually made it all the way into quarterfinal or semifinal, and almost had a chance to compete at the state tournament. But here, having Metro teams go at it, I mean, it's really some fierce competition out here.
A staple of St. Paul City Conference ball.
As Deion Bradley goes in for the layup and gets fouled. 24.4 seconds remaining in the ball game. Highland Park up by 11, 72-61.
And I think if anything, folks who are watching this might start giving you a few calls for basketball. I know that a lot of folks associate you with the Packers and the NFL with the current research you've been doing.
I'll take the work anywhere I can get it.
But this guy knows a thing or two about basketball. It's followed the Lynx since their very first game.
June 12th, 1999, as Deion Bradley hits the free throw. Down to 20 seconds in regulation.
How did Tashiva Shaw keep that in play? And he gets the foul. No, it's a timeout.
Still 13 seconds.
Tashiva Shaw somehow kept it in bounds, getting the rebound and getting the finish. I don't think there's a question. He's the player of the game for Como Park.
Oh, for Como, it's hands down. He is the player. At the first half, I really thought it was going to be Terrence Williams, but the second half, he's actually been a disappointment. But Shaw, he's single-handedly kept this team alive on the backs of his shoulders and on his legs. And they, even though with only 13 seconds left, they're still down by 10, it could have been a whole lot worse had Shaw not stepped up and showed some good leadership.
And that's something Steve Scroggins is going to promote and I imagine feel good about as he heads to his next game.
Hey, the kid's a sophomore. If he's showing this kind of talent as a sophomore, wait till he's a junior, wait till he's a senior. And Como Park is going to have a player that is going to be a force to reckon with in St. Paul City League. And somebody who is going to really make a big difference as this team goes on from this point forward.
Don't hold!
Daryl Hill.
And they're still pressing. And they get the 5 second
call. 5 second call with 13 seconds left. You gotta give Steve Scroggins some credit too. You know, even though it's a short season, even though his team is down, you know you're gonna lose, he still is doing the best he can to work with their development as players. As Denzel Shaw goes up for the shot, gets fouled, but no call. We're down to 5 seconds left.
Bennett Cooper will get the last basket of the game. 73-65, Highland Park with the victory. And we're going to get a word with our players of the game shortly. You really have to credit the work ethic of both teams, neither of them giving up, neither of them stopping until the final buzzer. This was just a well-played game and a highlight game within the St. Paul City Conference. And as Jeff Williams pointed out, we got to keep an eye on Tashiva Shaw over the next few years. That kid will be fun to watch for Como Park and Highland Park, loaded with talent as well. Steve Scroggins told me yesterday in pregame interviews that John DePerry was long overdue for his chance at head coach, and I can see why. They both have great admiration for each other. So we're going to get an interview with players of the game coming up.
St. Paul's Highland Park, 73, and tonight we had Tyshawn Williams leading with 21 points, 0 fouls. Daryl Hill had 21 points and 1 foul. Cordaro Washington, 14 points, 4 fouls. Deion Bradley picked up 10 points and 1 foul. Nate Anderson played limited minutes tonight, but he picked up 1 foul to go with no points. Ryan Vaught Fitzpatrick had 4 points and 3 fouls. Terrence Lee, 3 points, 2 fouls, and Jordan Stewart, 0 points and 1 foul. And for the home team, St. Paul's Como Park, Tashiva Shaw led all scorers with 23 points. He had no fouls. Terrence Williams, 16 points, 2 fouls. Denzel Shaw had 12 points and 0 fouls. Bennett Cooper, 6 points, 2 fouls. Vaughn Pledger, 3 points, 3 fouls. Najee Kennedy, 3 points and 2 fouls. And Andre Perry, with 0 points, picked up 4 fouls. 73-65, visiting Highland Park, win by 8 points over Como Park.
Mike Peden here with the Como Park player of the game, Kaishiva Shaw. Didn't come out with the win tonight, but what we saw on the court is just admirable for anybody who's wanting to play basketball. You guys never gave up. You kept pressing all the way to the very end.
Thank you.
And in you in particular, we just saw you smiling on the court. I mean, you're just having fun out there. That's what Steve Scroggins told us you like to do. And so you're just going out there. What are you trying to learn as you develop as a sophomore?
I'm just trying to play the game and get my skills up. And that's all I want to do, trying to get my skills back up.
And what does playing a team like Highland Park do to improve that skill set and develop it?
I mean, they did what they had to do, and my team didn't. I had to step up, you know, for my team, so they did a good job.
Well, and you stepped up in a big way, and you can make an argument that without your work ethic tonight, which is very strong, this game might have been a blowout, but Como Park fought with Highland to the end and set things up for what could be a very close second battle later on in the conference. So where did you get that work ethic and just that positive energy? Because every time you were out on the court, that's all we could sense.
God gave it to me. He gave me a gift, and, you know, I got to keep on working on it.
So what will Como Park work on as they continue St. Paul City Conference play after playing an up-and-coming team with Highland Park?
Just keep working hard, and we're going to take champ if we keep working hard.
And is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on television or online on Grand Stadium?
I want to say hi to my mom, my dad, and my grandma. I see you, y'all.
Well, I'm sure they enjoyed that shout-out. Thank you for taking the time to speak with us, and a great performance tonight. Your Como Park is going to be a fun team to watch no matter what the score is.
Thank you.
Kaishiva Shaw, Como Park's player of the game, will have the Highland player of the game shortly. Mike Peden here with Highland Park's co-players of the game, Tyshawn Williams and Daryl Hill, and you two just lit things up from the Scots, especially from the start. So tell me, how did you keep Como Park from getting to a big lead early that led to a huge run for you guys?
I think the box and one that we ran on Terrence, because that let all of our defensive players help each other out as one. So then, like, we got a lot of rebounds to kick the ball up, because we knew that it was going to run up and down the court. So once we stopped Terrence, then we could slow the game down in the half court.
Yeah, and it's a team effort, you know, the extra passes and freed people up and got people open so we can knock down shots, and the rest of our team could as well.
And speaking of team effort, head coach John DePerry told me that your team's really bought into a system in its first year, Highland Park in position to get its first winning season in 5 years. So what has DePerry brought to the Highland Park Scots that maybe wasn't there this time a year ago?
The most, I say, is discipline. In practice, he makes sure we're disciplined. and make sure we run through the plays over and over in defense.
Yeah, and he brought a lot of enthusiasm to the defense. He's making us buy into the defensive system, and without defense, you can't win games. So.
Certainly, and a nice bounce back after St. Paul Johnson had a dominant performance the last time. So what does a team like Como Park do to help you improve and prepare for a second match with Johnson and the tough teams in Class 3A?
Just keep working hard, because everybody thought we would lose because we lost to Central, and Como just beat Central. So we came out here and showed that we could beat Como as a team. So we had to work hard as a team, because on Tuesday night, we fell apart.
That's pretty much it.
And maybe talk a little bit about yourselves and maybe what you two have done over the years, what you think of each other for the Highland Park team.
I think we're growing a lot of chemistry, working hard in practice, especially playing like two, 3 years in a row and over the summer. So we just know when our players is open, who's hot, and who can knock down a shot.
Yeah, I mean, not just us two, but everybody, the whole team. We've been together, not more than any other team, but we've been together for these 2-3 years, and we've gotten to know each other, built up chemistry, so we can play better together.
And finally, anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on television or online?
I want to say thanks to my mom, and rest in peace, my auntie.
Yeah, my mom too.
Well, your mothers, I'm sure, will be jumping for joy for that shout-out, but thank you for taking the time to speak with us. Congratulations. This was a highlight game of the St. Paul City Conference. This was fun to watch.
Thank you.
Tyshawn Williams and Daryl Hill, Highland Park's players of the game. That does it from here. Highland Park coming out with the win. For everyone here at TSB Television, I'm Mike Beaton. Thank you for watching.